Today's topic, I'm Dr. Aditi Kulkarni. My today's topic is footwear ergonomics. Without wasting much time, we'll directly jump to the topic. There is stepping the right direction for the better health. Most of the people ignore their footwear whenever they are into the walking or into the jogging or the jumping or any kind of professionals. So it's utmost important that the entire posture, the knee pain, the osteoarthritic conditions, the spondylosis, lysis, listhesis conditions are in other way round are associated with even your foot health. That's why today's topic is going to be based on the entire session is going to be based on what are the footwears you have to wear and which is the right footwear to choose in the athletes as well as in the daily routine. Why importance of the ergonomics came into the footwear industry and why the healthy feet and everything? Because most of the people keep asking me whenever they come into the clinic, why then the footwear ergonomics? Because previously people used to walk barefoot, but now there are pavements, there is a brick, there is a n number of things which are very hard surfaces. And we all have become that much sedentary that we all have to take care about even your fit health. So there are certain job which demands a long standing hours. Like there are certain pharmaceutical industry, there are some of the other industries where people require to stand for a long period of time. That prolonged period definitely goes up to almost around 7 to 8 hours. Then if there are certain conditions where you are going to walk for the prolonged period of time, there are some few people who have their professions where they have to climb up the stairs, they have to walk from this industry to the other industry, or a certain times of like general daily walking routine. When the bones and the foot are going to get, especially going to come in contact with the hard surfaces. And if your footwear is incorrect, definitely the entire pressure which is going to get generated is going to get unevenly distributed on the ankles as well as on the knee joint as well as on the hip joint, and ultimately that person will be more bent forward towards gravity, and then they complain about the pain at the lower back whenever the footwear is incorrect and it's related to the walking without with the help of the good fit footwear. Then there are certain people who are very short with the height. They prefer to wear the high heels, the fancy shoes, the quality of the product they don't even bother about. Go for the style, absolutely fine. The style, the fancy shoes, high heels, everything is absolutely fine for the once in a while, but definitely not on the daily basis. Because if you are going to use this kind of a footwear, it is because of that, automatically the quality of the footwear and the cushioning which is provided by that footwear is not going to support to the arches. And that ultimately puts uneven pressure and causes a misalignment of the posture. The habit of wearing high heels pointed shoes that causes the foot misalignment. How the foot misalignments are going to happen? Whenever the heel is can be the pointed or can be the fancy shoes are going to be there, the person who walks can be shifting his center of gravity from the left or can be from the right to left, left to right. Because of that, automatically it puts on pressure. The arches are not supporting that particular person's time of walking, and that causes a heel pain or otherwise the calcaneal spur or otherwise the knee arthritis, because the cue angles are shifting, the patellas are shifting, their postures are getting into the misalignment. The wrong size shoes or otherwise the too tight shoes can be leading to the even fungal infections in that particular person. What kind of a footwear is good for me? If I'm wearing that particular footwear, which is of a very best brand, but still I'm not, my foot skin is not breathable. If the foot size is wrong, it is too tight for me, then definitely that good brand is also not going to help you at all. There are certain conditions in the athletes or otherwise in the sports person is at most important to get notified is as the pronated foot. The pronated foot or the adult flat feet or the congenital flat feet, chondromalacia patelli, proprioception exercises when they are performing after the surgical intervention are the utmost important conditions. You need to pay attention what kind of a footwear that person is wearing. Because if you are not wearing the comfortable footwear, as well as there are certain conditions when the person is not into a complete support system, can be the arches or can be the support system with the outer aspect, the sole of the foot, then definitely that person's performance is going to get reduced, the productivity, the creativity, everything is going to get hampered. So it's our utmost important. These are the conditions also we have to pay attention even in the daily routine as well as whenever the person is into the performance sports. Can be the marathon runners, can be the football players, can be the golf, anything. Always important is that is your footwear as well as your foot health. There are certain myths I come across. The higher heels is the better. So in the medical terminologies, we consider the calf muscles are the second heart of your body. That means they pump the deoxygenated blood supply, which get pumped towards your heart, and then automatically the entire oxygenation, the quality of the circulation improves. That's why even we pay after the surgical interventions, pay attention to the calf muscle strength as well. So there are certain people came across because they came across certain articles on the Google, like wearing a high heel. So automatically the activation of the calf muscle. It's completely wrong, dear. Because whenever we are wearing the high heels, definitely it is going to hamper your circulation as well as it is going to lead to misalignments of your body postures. As long as the price is right, I didn't even care about the quality. There are certain footwear I came across. There are many companies which people even use it whenever they are into the performance sports. They are the costing is around 10K or even the 15K, even the 50K. There are N number of quality products I have seen. But as long as it is not giving the right kind of a support to your foot, if it is pronated, there should be arches. If there is, they are not pronated, there shouldn't be the arches. There are neutral kind of footwears also comes in the market. There has to be the cushioning which they have to provide it to you. If those things are lacking in that quality, very high brand, very costly footwear, definitely this footwear is not for you. It's all about style. There are certain people who pay more attention to this, but they don't pay attention to the footwear health. So the foot health, it is definitely going to damage the entire spine, entire bony structures, and it is going to put an uneven pressure on the entire alignments of your body postures. So avoid doing that. That's why the ergonomics has become the huge business in the footwear industry. These are certain these are the certain footprints which I have taken from the even the patients and even from the internet. You will come across a number of apps are there which will show you kind of an impressions, and you will be able to assess the actual footprints of that particular patient. These are certain pressure points. There are red marks which are the metatarsal pads. The blue marks is the actual fleshy part, and the white marks are I'm showing the arches of that particular foot. So in the comparison of the two, you will be able to make out the flat feet is more on the right as well as on the left. So the comparative, the more one is more as compared to the left. So why these things are happening is because when the aging process has started, automatically the muscular tightness, the flexibility, the circulation which is getting provided by the body is getting hampered. So if these things are also happening after the age of 18 and you are still into the performance sports and not paying attention to the footwear which you are wearing, and otherwise if the wear and tear of the footwear has happened, otherwise in the daily routine also, if you are going for the fitness like a cardiac exercises on the treadmill or otherwise in the park, you are going for a walk and still you are not paying attention to the footwear which you are using, automatically the one foot start getting pronated inward. Pronated, that means if you stand, you will understand the one feet is becoming tilted like this. So that tilt is a we'll call it as the, because it has to be like this, because the cushioning is going to provide from this inner aspect of the foot. If it is not provided, it will become flat like this. So because of that, automatically your fingers will be spreaded like this. The entire foot alignment is going to change. And because of that, these kind of impressions will come across, and that foot pressure without a metatarsal pads and everything will be able to assess. And then we can come to the conclusion that person need a proper assessment of that particular footwear, as well as they need a correction for that particular foot, so that the weight bearing will be improved. And there are certain conditions like osteoarthritis of knee and everything. So those conditions are also associated whenever there are the pronated feet or the flat feet or the adult flat feet is getting developed. You need to provide the insoles which are giving the corrections, but based on the actual assessment of that particular person, you will be able to give this kind of a imprints and this kind of a report. And so based on that, they'll be able to get the full correction of that particular flat feet. How exactly the flat feet look like? This spring, which I have shown in that one particular picture, that act like a shock absorber for each and every person in their entire life. if this medial arch support, the longitudinal arch support or the lateral arch support is getting reduced, automatically that fit will start getting completely resting on the floor whenever that person is standing. So you are able to make out immediately that knee is also getting bent a little whenever the flat fit is happening. So the entire mechanism, the entire misalignment will start happening. So whenever the patient comes to me, I start assessing of that any athlete or the general patient also from top to bottom. From the bottom to top. That means from the ankles to the head. So when the postural assessment are completely done, then we come across there are certain conditions. They have developed the flat feet, which is nowadays pretty much common in the people who are working in the IT industry. If they are continuously sitting by keeping their legs hanging or otherwise without taking the footrest and not doing any intermittent stretches, because of that also, this is one of the reasons that people start getting this kind of a flat feet, and wearing the wrong footwear is definitely the reason that they are landing up into this kind of a flat feet mechanism, and that puts a lot of pressure and ultimately they are into the misalignment. And in certain conditions, we have seen they are developing the spine conditions also, which in the later stage becomes the non-recoverable, becomes the operative condition. So initial stage only people start correcting the root causes, definitely the entire alignment, the entire posture, as well as the strengthening of that particular muscle will be helpful for you. These are the effects of the reduced arches on the postural misalignments. Whenever the arches are getting reduced, automatically all the legs will turn inward. So there are certain people who develop the varum or the varus kind of a deformity. The varus is very pretty much common in the people who have developed the flat feet, which is the medial arch support is getting reduced. There are other conditions also, but the genu recurvatum and the genu varus is pretty much common in the people with the reduced arches. And that ultimately puts the pressure on the heel, then the thigh, and then the leg muscles. So this is, you all can make out as a physiotherapist or a medical professional, this is a course of sciatic nerve, which is the tibial nerve, the sciatic nerve. There are certain branches of that. If the person is complaining about only the simple tingling sensations or otherwise the muscular weakness has started developing to the one feet, definitely I suggest everyone and all the, even the students, that always go for the assessment of the flat feet. If the correction is provided, definitely at least a 20 to 30% issues will be able to solve there itself. Effects on reduced arches on the postural misalignments. Whenever we see, there are certain conditions patients complain about. When they are sitting for the prolonged period of time, that prolonged period might be extending from that pause. Otherwise, whenever they are climbing up and climbing down the stairs, but more precisely climbing down the stairs, if they are having a flat feet, they will start getting aches and pains into their bony prominences or the joints. So if or otherwise they feel the stiffness in that particular part, that means the stiffness can be in the heel or the calf muscle stiffness, and they get very much difficult to get up from the bed or to get up from the chair or to get up from the sofa or climb down the stairs, and their knees hurt. So if the person is not having even the arthritic changes, there is no ligament issues, there is no chances of having chondromalacia patellae or anything, but still that person is complaining the pain below the patella, that means the knee, the bone is there, the patella. So the knee is becoming in the bent posture, the patella came in the prominent manner, and below that there is a bursa. So if the patient is complaining about a recurrent bursitis or otherwise there is a continuous pain above the tibial joint, so those are the things where we have to pay attention. Actually that person having an issue with the knee joint or the hip joint, or that person is actually facing an issue with the adult flat feet, which was not there since birth. That's why that person might have failed to pay attention to that particular condition, or might be the footwear assessment is definitely required in that condition. Where exactly that person is going wrong, that's why these conditions are happening with that particular person. Whenever the pressure analysis we are going to do, always tell that person to walk for the 15 minutes, and then the 15 minutes is the running time. Can be the sport jogging as well in the pandemics, whenever that person is going to come. So always remember, always remember there are conditions when the person start walking or the jogging, they in the visible manner you'll be able to make out where the posture is leaning, either to left or to the right, or otherwise that person is having a protracted shoulders, or that person is leaning forward, the bent forward posture. It can be from the thoracic spine or it can be from the hips. There are certain assessment criteria which you can go for, then take the prints, and based on that prints, do the assessment of that particular person's footwear. So if the weight bearing is more on the right side, more on the left side, basis on the medial arch support, the lateral arch support, you will be able to assess properly. And taking the prints by taking on the, even the simple paper will also will help you tell that person to stand on that and take the prints and analyze it where exactly the lacking of that person is there. And you can get the pressure analysis and you can give the report. Based on that, you can design the footwear as well. These are the certain commonly footwear I come across. There are the supports are lacking. There is no shock absorption because of the very hard surfaces. These are the most commonest reason that people land up into the overuse injuries of the ankle or the knee or the hip, or sometimes in a very often cases is the back, the tendon injuries and the joint instability, or the hypermobility or the laxity of the ligaments also, or the tendons is also pretty much common in the athletes whenever the people are wearing these kind of a footwear. There are certain people come across, I have come across, they are wearing very good footwear, the perfect fit at the time of their routine, whenever they are going for the sports activity, whenever they are going for the gym activity, whenever they are going for the certain activities which is related to their professional habits. But in the daily routine at the home, or otherwise whenever they are going out, or whenever they are partying somewhere, they are not paying attention what kind of footwear they are using. So this is a message for you all. If you're not, you are a professional person and there is a foot health is required and it's a performance based, or certain times it is the static postures like a sitting for the prolonged period of time or standing for the prolonged period of time, make sure even at the time of your relaxation or the leisure time as well, your footwear makes a lot of difference, because that one single moment is the one moment of micro traumas to your all the spinal structures, even to your muscles, even the circulation can get hampered. Even the micro fractures is one of the thing can lead into the future. I recently come across one case, the person who was going to football matches every day on the cycle, but one day he took a Ola or the Uber. And then after reaching there, there are microfractures we've noticed, and now that person is in the pain. But after the rest and icing and everything, the physiotherapy sessions we took online, he recovered. But why this thing had happened? Because the stagnancy also makes a lot of difference, because previous stretches was not done. The second thing is that the footwear he was wearing every day was perfect at the time of his sports activity, but not in the daily routine activity. So that helped him because of that particular thing. His entire muscles were into the complete contraction, and the sudden relaxation and the sudden contraction because of the excess amount of blood supply during the sports activity made him land up into that pain and the injury. So avoid doing that. Make sure always remember to have the good support, good shock absorption, and avoid having the overuse injury by wearing the wrong kind of footwear which are not giving a proper support to you. These are one of the thing that nerves are getting involved, and these are the one-sided pain are pretty much common in the people who are having a wrong footwear, who are wearing the wrong footwear, which is not the snug fit to their foot, otherwise the arches support are lacking, and because of that they're leaning on one side and the compression of the nerves has started happening, and the visible reports of postural scoliosis will be able to see in the x-rays or the in the MRIs. So these are the things from the base course you'll be able to correct, and you'll be able to the correct guidelines to the patients as well. This is how the corrected arches look like wherever the person is into the pronated feet or the adult flat feet. The arch is going into the inward direction. Because of that, automatically the entire pressure of the body is leaning from left to right. Whenever you put insole, the insole has to be giving a support to the heel pad, even the medial arch support, the lateral arch support, and the metatarsal pad, below that there is a longitudinal arch. For that also you need to give the full support system to that particular foot. Never give only the arch pad for the medial. Always remember the sole which you are going to design or the footwear which you are going to design for that particular person has to be covering from the fingers up to the heel. there are certain conditions I came across. There are multiple brands are working in this industry. They provide either the foot support or otherwise the heel support, otherwise the medial head support. But this is not going to help you. Always remember the correction of the entire feet by taking the prints or correction of the entire alignments which you have to take in consideration. Then and then only that person will be able to come across, will be coming out of that particular situation. Yes, say that if you feel hurt and you hurt all over, because there are many people who come across, there are calcaneal spurs or everything is getting developed and we are not able to walk, but automatically they are complaining about the knee pain, the thigh pain, the hip pain, or otherwise the spinal pain. Yes, your feet plays a very important role in your alignments as well as in the entire structures of your body. The postural misalignments or the alignments in the runners. There are certain athletes or the certain marathon runners or certain conditions wherever we come across, they some people run on the midfoot. Some people run on the forefoot. Some people run on the any kind of, the forefoot, the midfoot, or otherwise they are certain are with the heel touch. Now I want to show you one picture. The girl who is running on the very hard surface, the footwear which she is wearing, the footwear is like this. The fingers are coming up, the midfoot is touching properly, and the heel part is little again up. So whenever this kind of a footwear you are using, it will give a proper cushioning and actual dynamic activity will be getting activated whenever you are wearing this kind of footwear. Whenever this kind of activity, because certain runners or certain sports players are still learning into the learning phase. So we are teaching them, are you a slow runner? Are you a fast runner? Are you a medium kind of a runner? And what are the muscles should get activated? Knee position should not be beyond your toe level at the time of running. You need to put a more foot, forefoot whenever it's a activation of the, and it's a fast running. Whenever you are running on the any grass surface or the very hard surface, you have to put your midfoot. But again, your footwear. If the footwear is completely flat like this kind of a person, and otherwise, and you are running with this kind of a flat footwear on the very hard surfaces, definitely your speed and the performance will be less. So always remember, the footwear has to be equally, it should give the distribution of the body weight evenly. It should restore your balance whenever you are touching again the feet on the ground. It should improve your posture rather than making you slouch in the front part. The overall spinal alignment should get maintained. The toning of the muscles throughout the body is at most on priority before running. The stretching, strengthening exercises, you have to pay attention. The back tension and the pain get relieved automatically whenever you are into the correct footwear on the correct surface and a correct technique of doing that particular task. To prevent falls, sprains and injuries also, these kind of a footwear help you. Always remember, these are the certain features you have to check even in the daily routine and even for the athletic conditions, like which footwear to go for and which one to buy. Always remember, the first point is the freedom of the movement of the toes. Your finger, whenever you're putting inside the shoe, you have to move your fingers and then decide it's actually for me or not. The inner side of the shoe must be straight from the heel to the end of the big toe. Later on, the pictures are going to come how exactly it is going to be. The fastening across the instep to prevent the foot from the slipping when walking. Whenever you are going to walk, walk with the heel strike. Heel, then the midfoot, then the forefoot. Just walk with that particular shoe so that it will be a brisk walk, the fast walk, or otherwise at the time of your training, if you're doing a certain exercises, it will give a firm grip to you. Shoe must grip the heel firmly. If the heel is, I'm wearing the footwear, my fingers are moving, everything is a good support system, but already I have developed my pronated feet and I'm wearing that neutral shoe. That time if my heel is moving inside, it will not give you a proper support. So always remember, the gripping of the heel as well as your toes freedom is our utmost on priority. So that can be even the 200 rupees shoe also, but that will be the best shoe for you. A low wide base heel, the heel counter provided the rear foot stability. What is rear foot stability? Wherever you are putting with the heel, then the midfoot, then the forefoot. With that mechanism, there should be the firm support. You should feel the firm grip at the time of walking, whether it's a running shoe or not. So that particular stability you have to check and then only buy any footwear. What to look for the best walking or the running shoes? Always remember the better fit, the durability, definitely. The full rubber outsole rather than the small blocks. There are certain footwear comes with the one small block and then there is a widespread foot support. So don't go for those kind of a thing. There has to be the one rubber support which is covering the entire sole. So even in the girls, it's a foot flip-flops or the chappals which has the entire sole. And for the boys, I always suggest even if it's the office wear or otherwise outer wear, you always have to pay attention about the full support system, the rocker sole, the versatile and the multifunctional styling. Now, this is the transition. Your body should favor whatever you're using. This is the anatomy of the footwear, as I just mentioned. The outsole, the outer sole, the midsole and the shank has to be covered with the entire support system of the sole. The toe cap has to be fully supported with that particular sole. The toe box, the laces, the upper tongue, the heel collar, the heel tab, the heel contour. When the heel contour we are considering, that heel should get snug fit over there. The finger should be lifted up. The heel collar has to be coming up to only the where the metatarsals are ending. So that particular part will be covering with either the sole or otherwise like a slip-on kind of condition. The entire collar is going to come and end up there. Why exactly? In the daily routine also, you have to choose the correct footwear. Always remember the convex sole, the heel-to-toe motion while walking. And for those who stand for the prolonged period of time, pay attention which footwear you're going for is like this. So this is how the condition is going to be helping you. It helps to increase the back muscle activity. It aligns your body into the correct posture like the shoulder levels and even the ear levels. It strengthens and tones the core muscles whenever you're walking because tucking your stomach abdominal muscles inside will help you to make you upright. Increase the glute and thigh calf muscles activity, reduces the stress on the ankle joint, stabilizes and guides foot strike, promotes energy returns and reduces stress on the knee joint. Whenever you are into the good corrected ergonomic footwear, your capacity to do the particular task, your efficiency, your productivity and the energy conservations are going to be there for sure. So whenever you are into the performance sports, you always remember to go for the correct footwear for yourself. These are certain good brands which I came across. That's why I'm showing those things. There are certain, I'll show it to you. There are certain brands like LNG, Kekun series, then A6 gel contented series, then the Adidas Throp series, the Adidas Drago series. Then the Skechers Go Run series, then the neutral and the good stability shoes. There are Brooks, there are overpronated shoes. There are certain shoes. These are the Kerenji Keprun the series is one of the thing which I quite liked. This is one of the good footwear which I came across. There are certain conditions you have to get your assessment done from the physiotherapist. They will give you the correct report, which one is applicable in those kind of good brands as well. So which one is pronated for, which is for the woman, which is for the boys, which is for the young girls, which is for the young athletes, which is for the which kind of sports. Then these are the runner shoe, which I'm showing you right now. These are the shoes I came across for the pronated and the neutral shoes. So these are the one. Anatomy of the chappals, if you'll go for. Take care of your feet. The ergonomic sole provides a proper support for the different parts of your feet to reduce the foot fatigue. The middle aspect of that particular thing has to be raised with the proper correction from the medial arch. The firm support has to be provided for the heel. The medium support and the soft support has to be balanced with that particular support system. And always remember, like the shoe, you always have to lift your fingers also up. So automatically the entire feet is going to get a full support. And you will be out of the fatigue even at the time of walking. And these kind of the same footwear I advise to the people who are going to choose a footwear even for the home purpose. So that will be for the prolonged period of time, especially for the people who work on in the kitchen for the prolonged period of time. They stand for the prolonged period of time. The shock absorption mechanism has to be correct and you have to choose the correct footwear. Fitflop is one of the best footwear which I came across. This is the company. Nowadays, it is little difficult to get easily available in the on the internet. This is how actually when you're wearing the footwear with the fitflops, with the correct sole and the correct finger raised and the arches support is going to provide it to you. This is how exactly the high density absorbs up to 22% more shock in the lower legs to help relieve the joint stress. This is the best thing what you can give it to your legs. The low density in the mid shaft, that means the medial, so middle part of the particular footwear, the midsection creates the instability, which is the lower leg muscle activation back to 11%. Because if you're continuously standing, then if you're not able to recall that you have to do the stretches in between, this is one of the thing which will make your muscles, the longitudinal arch muscles, the medial arch support system, and even the lateral arch support system will be completely activated. The mid-density, the two-cap helps to maintain the speed, pace, and increase stability. If you're choosing the correct kind of footwear, even at the time of chappals, these are the one. This is how exactly it will look like whenever this is getting maintained. Negative heel is one of the concept everybody in the medical point of view should understand. The slopes upward towards the toe. The toes are actually supported 3.7 degree higher than the heel, creating the feeling of walking on the sand. To offset the negative effect of the wearing high heels on the regular basis, you always important to choose the negative heel. That means this one. The fingers are raised, the heel is supported firmly, raised a little higher, and the mid shaft is in the little flexible way. So this is the basic information. Definitely the physiotherapy exercises will going to help you to maintain the good arches of the feet. There are certain brands who will help you to sustain for the prolonged period of time into the the prolonged period of time for the better performance in the sports activity or even in the daily routine activity. Even whether you are doing the sport jogging or the sport walking at home in the pandemic, definitely do not ignore your foot health. Do not ignore the footwear which you are wearing. Always remember to choose the correct chappal and choose the correct footwear is one of the key to avoid n number of damages to the spinal structures, to the knee joints, or otherwise the postural misalignments. Think feet first. Thank you for removing your shoe. This is kind of a thing which I always tell to the people. Do not avoid wearing the very high heel, the pointed heels, to avoid misalignments. If there are any questions, you can contact me. Thank you so much for being so patient at the time of